So in our last period, in chapter integers, we learned about positive numbers and negative numbers. What is the meaning of positive number? What is the meaning of negative number? Also, we have learned how to show positive numbers and negative numbers on number lines. Now, we will learn the addition of integers. For that, we will observe these figures. Now see here. Addition of integers. Okay. Now see here, in this figure, at first, the rabbit was at the number. At which number the rabbit is here? It is at plus 1. Okay, so here in this box, plus 1. Then it hopped. How many units it hopped? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it hopped 5 units. So here in second box, there is 5. So he hopped 5 units to the right. Okay. And now it is at the number where at plus 6. So therefore, here 1 plus 5, that is equal to plus 1 plus 5, that is equal to 6. Now in second figure, at first the rabbit was at number, here is minus 2. At first the rabbit was at the number minus 2. It hopped. How many units? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units. It hopped 5 units to the right. And it is now at the number plus 3. Now the rabbit is at the number plus 3 here. And therefore, minus 2 plus 5, we get plus 3. So, from these two figures, we will understand that to add a positive number to the given number, we move that many units to the right on the number line from the given number. Okay, that means if we want to add positive number to a given number, and the term, we have to move that many units to the right. Now see here, in next figure, now here, rabbit hops to the left. Now see here, at first, rabbit was at the number, where is at the number minus 3 here. Okay. At first, the rabbit was at minus 3. Now, he hopped to the left. So how many units he hopped? 1, 2, 3, 4. So he hopped 4 units to the left. It is now at the number where? Now it is at minus 7. So here we get minus 3 plus minus 4 is equal to minus 7. Why this is minus 4? Because the rabbit hopped 4 units to the left. So here we get minus 4. And in next figure, at first rabbit was at the number here, plus 3. Now, how many units he hopped? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 4 units. He hopped 4 units to the left. And 4 units. And it is now at unit minus 1. So, here plus 3 plus minus 4 is equal to minus 1. Now, here we get the statement here, to add a negative number to the given number, we move that many units to left on the number line from the given number. That is, we move backward on the number line, which means we subtract. That means, if we move backward on the number line, that means we subtract. Now see here. Now we will show the amount we have. The amount which we have, or the amount which we get as a positive number, and the amount which we borrow, or the amount which we spend, will show that amount by negative number. Suppose I have 5 rupees, that means that number is plus 5. I have 5 rupees. Again, I get 3 rupees from my friend, or my friend gave me 3 rupees. That means that number is also plus. So now I have total amount plus 5 plus 3 is equal to plus 8. So I have amount rupees 8, that is positive number. Now suppose I borrow 5 rupees from my friend, then that means I have minus 5 rupees, that number is minus. Okay, now again I borrowed 3 rupees from my friends, that means again that number is minus 3. So here, so total amount borrowed by me is minus 8. So in this way, we will solve examples of addition of integers. Now for addition of integers, so we have rules for addition of integers. Now these rules are, see here, first, when adding integers with the same sign, ignore the signs and add the numbers, then give the common sign to their sum. First rule,
when adding integers with the same sign. Ignore the signs and add the numbers, and then give the common sign to their sum. For example, plus 7 plus plus 5. Now see here, plus 7 plus 5, both have same signs. So here, first we will ignore these signs. We will add these numbers. 7 plus 5 will get 12. And the common sign is here plus, so give the plus sign to the sum. So plus 7 plus plus 5, here we get plus 12. Now another example, minus 7 plus minus 5. Now see here, both the integers have same sign, but both have negative signs. So first, ignore these signs. Only add the numbers. 7 plus 5, we get 12. And the common sign is minus here, so write minus sign to the sum. So here, the sum is minus 12. Now the second rule. When adding integers with different signs, ignore the signs and subtract the smaller integer from the bigger one. Then give the sign of the bigger number to the difference obtained. Now for example, plus 12 plus minus 5. Now see here, this is positive integer and this is negative integer, there is addition. Now see here, the signs are different. One is positive, one is negative. Now in such case, ignore the signs. Do not consider signs. Then what to do? Subtract smaller number from bigger number. So here 5 is smaller, 12 is bigger. So subtract 5 from 12. So here we get 7. 5 minus 12 minus 5, we get 7. And write the sign of bigger number. So bigger number is 12 and sign of 12 is plus. So write plus 12. Plus 7. So here the addition is plus 7. Or minus 12 plus 5. Now here is also different signs are here, minus plus. Now here bigger number is negative, smaller number is positive. In this case also, similarly like this case, first ignore the signs. Do not consider signs and subtract smaller number from bigger number. That means 12 is bigger. Subtract 5 from 12, we get 7. And give the sign of bigger number to the difference. So difference is 7. And here bigger number is 12 and sign of 12 is minus, so give minus sign to this difference. So this addition is, your answer is minus 7. In this way you can use the rules. Now using these rules, we'll solve practice set 5 in next period.